And so in the early 1990s, we in the ketogenic diet for epilepsy world were not in a great place. The diet was really kind of seen as a therapy of last resort, only in children, and for the most part, even in the early 90s, only in the United States. If you went to the American Epilepsy Society meeting, a great conference, you'd be hard-pressed to find anything about the ketogenic diet there in the early 90s. Maybe a poster here and there, but no sessions, no lectures, really very little at that time. Articles written about the ketogenic diet would put it into alternative medicine. We now consider it more non-pharmacologic. That's often where it ends up. But at the time, it was sort of perceived as alternative, and we really came a long way to say it's actually not alternative. It's just different. Now today, it is everywhere. It is all over the place. You've seen some great screenshots. I know the Wall Street Journal this morning, amazing. But this is from Time Magazine, New York Times. They love to show bacon all the time. I think it photographs well. I think that may be what it is. We always kid around about it. But the parents see this, you know, and the parents are interested, and they're looking for other ideas for their children with epilepsy. And it's great that this is coming out in the popular media.